Hello everybody, it's Els here, Elizabeth Craft Designs. Happy Friday! So we are ready for a live. Let me see myself there so that works. How are we all doing? The weekend started in the Netherlands already, I think. Just talk to Josette, she's going to Amsterdam tonight, which is great. Hello, so Annette, hi Annette. And we don't, now they have star badges, we don't do that. So, just waiting to see till people are coming in. Is it a nice, day in the Netherlands? I don't know, I don't see all the comments, I only see one comment. So something is not doing well. Okay, now I see, hello, Yvonne from Puerto Rico and Anita. Okay, now they're coming in, I just had to. Don't know what I did, but somehow it's working now. So that's always nice. Debbie. So, you know, so Debbie English is here. Debbie, we're not friends. You're not in the family group, I think, Debbie. But Debbie was here on the Wednesday. And she was talking about a pie, about an apple pie. And said, oh, if I see you yesterday, bring some apple pie. She bought a full pie. Like a full pie. Debbie, there is not a lot left. I went to my sister, so we had a little piece in the store, then I went to my sister in Calgary, we had apple pie there, and then I took the rest home, and there's a little piece in the fridge left, but everybody loved it, so full pie. Hi everybody, hi Terry, hi Tracy, Joke, Wilma, Petra, hi Dina, and Honora, hi everybody, and Pat is here. So it's Friday, so almost weekend. So I am going to play with the ornaments from the Classic Christmas Special. I know there are some coming in from the Netherlands. They're actually on their way or they're here already. I don't know, but so we are good to go again with the Classic Christmas set because we were almost sold out of our US inventory. So I'm going to play. So what I did is I did several stencils. I made several stencils that I thought would work well or fun. Of course, this one from the latest release from Into the Woods. And before I forget to say the 19th and the 20th, so Sunday and Monday, we are the one day special on the craft store with the Into the Woods collection. And we also have some of the Home Jungle sets there. Because we didn't have that yet. Hi, Yona, you're in your vacation home. So so we are the one day special there. So if you didn't get your hands on the new release from Ilse and Charlene yet in Europe or on the Home Jungle set, we are the one day special on Sunday and Monday. And I'm going to do the first 2 hours on Sunday. And then Charlene is doing the first hour, the 8 a.m. UK time on Monday. And then the two after that, I will do again. Monterey, that's a beautiful place, isn't it? Yeah, pretty sure. Linda's here. Hi, everybody. Okay, that's good. That's good, Cindy. Yes, it is to be here again. So we're all good. So, oh yeah, I really enjoyed it. Yes, they had a piece yesterday already, Debbie. Yeah. And Margarita from Bulgaria. Hi, everybody. So this is the Classic Christmas set. So I'm going to show it to you, but I'm basically going to do different techniques on the ornaments and not with the snowflakes because I showed you that in the special. And that's the background die that goes with it. And then, of course, the stamp sets. So that's all. So you get three die sets and then the stamp sets in the special. So this is the Classic Christmas. And our spotlight for this week is the... is the glitter and the tape, and the code for that is SPOTLIGHT20, and you get 20% discount on the glitter and the tape, so all sizes of tape, so you can do the big rolls, the sheets, and so that is for this week. Oh, sell the dark as you push. Yeah, I know. No, I make a lot. I make a lot, and of course I store them, so I have the ones that I've ready already in my little pizza boxes, of course. So what did I do? So these ones I have left. I have all the pieces here, and then I have my thin tape here, and I have my stencils here. So I'm just going to play with those, and then see how far we get, because there's so much fun things to do with that. And so let me start. I'm going to do this as well, but I want to start with a stencil. We were talking about the lacy leaves. So this is the lacy leaf die set. So this is only cut out of the release sheets. Yeah? Oh, wait. I need to get extra. Always watch that you have the extra pieces out. I want to figure out a way to put that background in my December DVD. Oh, that's like which one? You mean these ones? And you know, you can use everything, of course, in your December day by day. But this one, I also cut out of, you can also cut it out of tape, just a double-sided adhesive. Is Joep here as well? Joep is actually having hot chocolate, I think, with Tom somewhere. So I don't know if he is here. They were going out for a, there is a hotel here that has the best hot chocolates. Yeah, Joseph, feeling better? Better every day, I hope. Better every day. Of course, so this is a great stencil. And of course, you can imagine if you do that, I'm going to do the ornaments now, but you can imagine if you, for instance, make a strip of cardstock with tape, and you put these on the side like this, that will be a really, really pretty background for a card as well. So think outside of the box with that one, because there's lots and lots to do with that. So let me grab an ornament. Let's start with a circle here, or this one. Let me see. I want to see how it kind of fits. This fits two leaves nicely. And would this fit? This would only fit. Oh, that could actually also be really nice. Okay, let's do two with this one, because I think this one, like this, will be pretty as well. Just going to do two. So again, so the discounts on the tape and the glitter. And the classic Christmas kit is, we got those extra back in stock. So again, you don't want to touch the tape. So I'm just, and I played with some, I got the embossing powder out and I got the foil out. So I just want to play a little bit with different things. Let me see if I fit the larger one on here. That could be. Let me try. So I'm going to put this one here, and then this one here. And those leaves, like the lace leaves, that's a very suitable one for a stencil. There we go. And of course, this is from the floral designs. Sorry, I'm off to make fifth apple cider. I'm coming back for the apple cider, Debbie. That must be delicious as well. So press this down, and this will make a great stencil. So what I would like to do in this case, I want to implement some foil as well. And of course, if you want to, you can even add an extra. Oh, that might actually be really pretty. But then I want to have that big one maybe. If I put that one here, that is nice. Wait. So for the stencil, of course, as long as you keep these in one piece, I keep repeating, but then you can use it over and over and over again. Wait, I want to have that tip in the center nicely placed. And then my release sheet and press it down. And of course, like and comment. And if you want to share, it's appreciated as well. And Monday, we do the other $50 gift certificate. And I think on Wednesday, we announced the $100 gift certificate for the Spotlight giveaway. Yeah, that's a nice pattern. You see, and now if I want to, and I like it, I have some green as well. I have several pieces of foil. Let me see. Let me do some. No, I'm doing gold, and then I'm doing a like a green leaf, that I think in there. So, oh, I should have done this on the side. That's a waste. So I'm pressing this down in here. So this will not catch everywhere. And that's what's so fun about this, because so I want to have it a little bit in the. And now I need to pull it off. And I noticed that this, because there is a difference in foil and foil, that's why we need to have our own foil at one point. Because this one, I noticed, sticks a little bit. And I have no idea which brand this is, because I just have some pieces here. You see, so I need to be careful that I don't pull up the tape. So I'm going to lift it up here carefully. And then from this side, you see, so this tape actually is not very, like the foil is a little bit more sticky to the tape. So there is a difference in that. There we go. So that's that. So now I have that here, and I actually see that I picked up some tape here, which is fine, because then I will do some embossing powder there. So what you see now is that tape kind of, that foil picked up at some parts, but not everywhere. And then I'm going to do some glitter, and I'm going to take the gold glitter. Let's do the light gold, or you can do the regular gold that I used earlier. Here we go. So do that. And what you're going to do, you're going to brush this off, but not completely, because then you're going to rub that the rest. So you see, so it's still a little bit on the leaf, because I like to rub the rest into that foil. My Belinda's here. You are a bit out of focus. Oh yeah, I see. Okay, sorry. Thank you about that. Thank you. Oh, like this. My camera's a bit high, I see. Yeah. Sorry about that. Thank you. Glad I looked. Okay, so that's the light gold that I'm using, but of course you can use any color. And then I'm going to rub this in. And what this does, it goes on the side where the foil didn't pick up. And see, that's that. And now I can lift up those leaves. And I can do, you know, let's do that in different colors this time. Because because this will be nice with different colors of green. And I'm going to lift this up because you will see that that foil is not all like you see that scratchy, like more, like, yeah, I don't know how to call that. But you see the scratches in there. That's because of the glitter. And that's what I like. So let me do different colors. And this, you know, you need to make sure it's clean, but that is ready to go for another one. So now I can actually do different colors. You know, let's do a turquoise one as well. Let's do some turquoise and some green. When you use the gold foil, else, if you use embossing powder instead of glitter, will it melt the gold foil? Well, I have no idea. I will try that in another one. Soup, because I have my, let's see, so now I have my blue leaf. It's a teal blue. And you will see with this one that if you polish it, there's such a huge difference here. Hello, Elizabeth from the UK. I just told, like, on Sunday the 19th, we will be the one day special on the craft store with the Home Jungle, but the new Into the Woods collection as well from Ilse and Shalene. So now I take this off. I'm going to do it green. You see, so check the dyes here, because some dyes are just really, really suitable for to make stencils. And then just play with those. And those stencils, as long as you have it, is that the teal blue or the soft? The blue streak, sorry. The blue streak. But like a teal color is the same. So this was the blue streak. And this is the spring peridot I'm using here. But all the, you know, all the colors will be nice. All the colors will be nice. See, that's that. And then I have one left. You see, and I'm going to do that one in the real green. Like the just green. Any stores in the US that have the Into the Woods collection? Joseph, I am sure there are. I don't know if there's stores here right now. But there will be, for sure. There are, because we shipped a lot already. I know if there's any store here, please make yourself notice. But yeah, there are. Live on TV, that's big, that's big. You see, what happened here now is that I, because that's where I kind of wrecked the foil a bit, or I pulled the tape off with that foil. So what I will do now, I will do right away the testing of the embossing powder, because I have that here, and I have this one here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of that ink on the edges so I can add some embossing powder. And then let's see if I set the house on fire. So let's see. Get your insurance policy out. Just going to see, because that's picking up. I'm doing a little bit of dabbing because I don't want to have it everywhere. I can kind of see where it picks up. Let's see what this does. I think that will be pretty. No fires. No, Cindy, no fires. Oh, yeah. Oh, Sue, yeah. Lori, is Lori from, she's from the Baldly, it's a difficult of a name. But I know we ship to lots of stores. So, Joseph, probably in your area as well, if you ask your local, or the one that you order only from, or they are around. Okay, let's see what happens. Maybe the foil goes bubbly, I don't know. I'm pretty sure I did it before, but I don't know the effects anymore. I'm going to lift it up a bit because I don't want my paper to burn, because I only have one here. No, I don't think anything happens to the foil. Because here I have some more, foil. Because of the, it's going to fall. So nothing will happen, because here's where it was damaged. So you see some more embossing powder here, but it's not the foil that came up. So that actually works well. But I will do an ornament with that combination. That will be nice. Okay, so let me put a top piece on this one. I think I will stick with the gold. Yeah, I love the, so the embossing powder works great on the, on the tape as well. There we go. And then what I did earlier this week, I kind of take like the diamond or something, because this is sticky, so I just dip it in here so it's not sticky anymore. Let's see. So that is one. So that's a kind of unique. I see I stick to the same colors a bit. You see? And if I want to hide my spot that I think is not as nice, I can just do it this way, whatever. So there is different ones. Okay, so let's see. What's the next one? What is the next one? I have... Oh, I want to show this as well, because we had... So I'm using stencils, but I also did one on that silver paper earlier. So it can be any color of paper, of course. So what I did with this one... And I think this one will work well. So I cut it out of a tape sheet. So I also have it as a stencil. But a stencil on this, because it's just cardstock, doesn't do anything. So I cut it out of tape sheets. And then I want to put it on here. And I see, because this stencil is kind of nicely connected. So I think it will work well. And I also thought right away, this one, I cut it up. But this one will be great on your photo folder. The technique we did with the snowflakes on Wednesday... So this one will be great on a photo folder. I think that will look really, really pretty. I have several here, so I will try that as well. Okay, careful where the tape is. Oh, the tape is on this side, so I just pick it up here. And see what happens if I pull that off. I think it will be a good one to do, but again, I didn't do it before. So, oh, it comes up there. Oh, maybe not so. Oh, yeah, there we go. I need to be careful, because it is has some circles that are. I think I'm good. Oh. Okay, let me see. I'm just going to pop it down. Let's see if the pattern will be nice. So just have it on here. Then I need to trim it, of course. But I think that will be a nice one as well. But some parts were a little bit more loose, I noticed. But we'll see. I think it will be pretty. That's a Christmas set. There's none in the US stores. Yeah, they are. So the Christmas set is online already. But the Into the Woods, you need to get through a retailer. And I know for sure there are more than one at ship as well. So, but you guys are helping each other. So that's good. That is good. Oh, I think I'm cutting in my ornament there. I think this will be a nice pattern. But of course, this is also, so I will use that same piece then as a stencil that I just took off. So you can see that here. So I think this will be fun. And then this one is especially nice when you add a like some rhinestones or something. That will be nice as well. So we're out of glitter dots. So I was in Calgary yesterday at Carol's place, Carol Paper Pastimes. And people were picking up the Christmas sets in store. And then and people were asking for the glitter dots. She is hiding them in a drawer. For if people get the Christmas set. So if you pick up the Christmas set at Carol's in Paper Pastimes, ask for the glitter dots in the drawer, in the special drawer. Okay, so now I'm taking it. So make sure, of course, press down well. So I think I did that. You see, that will be cool. There we go. And here's one loose piece. That is a nice pattern. That is a nice pattern. What I will do, I will, so question now is, I know I did one with, did I do the white? Let's do, I'm going to make like a more, call that pops. So I'm going to take that blue streak again. So it's, it pops up now. Here we go. So you see, so some patterns, so it you need to just see which pattern works well. But this one works really well on the ornaments as well. You see, so that's just a really nice stencil. But you can see right away. Oh, she is here. Carol is here. Carol, I hope you were hiding. I didn't see you yet. Yeah. So if you pick up that classic Christmas kit at Carol, Carol, I told you a little secret. She has a secret drawer with glitter dots. And they're not available anywhere. Like apparently they couldn't get the they can't get the raw material at the moment for that one, so I know. Yeah, Carol, you must have more, there were more drawers there. You probably have more secrets. I know Randy, because her daughter was there as well, Randy. And I think I got the impression that you have more secrets hiding. Yeah. There we go. And now the top piece. I do a gold one on this one. I know, it's a special drawer, yeah. She keeps it when people have special questions or special requests, so she has her secrets in the drawer. And I'll tell you, Carol also has a nice selection of shimmer sheets as well. And beautiful samples in the store. And shimmer sheets, some of you might not know it, but it's fantastic. So Carol, you can imagine now your glitter dots in here, you see? The ones you have, Carol. I actually have some here, but that would be really nice in here. Or little rhinestones, but the glitter dots would be really nice in there. You see, so you can see already that would be nice if it would have been gold in the combination, but just, you know, this is so much fun to do. Okay, next one. So I have it here on cardstock. I know you must have special treats. You do. How did your husband like the apple pie, Carol? Because the apple pie was fantastic. Okay, so this one, you see, so now what I took off from this, I'm using here now. And what I will do, I can cover the whole thing, but I think I like it best if I don't. You see, so now you can use this as a stencil. And you can use it over and over and over again. Carol, you might need to get ready for a big rush. I know. Everybody in Calgary is running to Carol for the glitter dots. I'll tell you, if she thinks that would happen, if everybody's going to run to Carol, she will make a secret drawer next to the secret drawer. So she will have them separated. Knowing Carol, she will be ready. No, they're sold out. No, they're sold out, but I have some more for special people. No, everybody is special. Every customer in Carol's store is special. Okay, so this one I'm going to do in red and green. Let's do red and green. So you see, cut some, and so now I can hold it this, and I'm not going to use this for this, because I showed you it earlier, and you get a lot of glitter on that then, and I don't want that. It works the cleanest when you try to stay away, oh, not do that, try to stay away. Now you might have to hire some aunties to, I know. Oh, you can, oh, Belinda, yeah, sorry. Sorry. You didn't. Oh, you just got a notification. Yeah, Jennifer. Well, you can always watch back. And this is also. Is there a Carol in Holland also? No, you can ask, but I don't think they're around at the moment. But you can ask your store because it's a Dutch product. So if they. But the last time we informed, they just didn't have the base material. But it could be that there are some at stores in the Netherlands, but I don't know. And a company that manufactures them, they are not online. So you need to ask a store. So brush it off. I always brush up the back as well. Keep it as clean as possible. Oh, you have some glitter dots? Okay, yeah, they are. Look at that, that is a fantastic stencil, you see? And this again, clean, ready for the rest one. Hi Sabina, nice, always, you're always on time. Or shall I pour, no, I was going to do red and green, let's stay that one. But I'm going to do one and pour embossing powder then on that. But if you want to go like classic, of course, the ornaments are great for, going classic with red, green, gold, silver. Oh, I do too. I have some here. For sure. I'm trying because now I'm with the RP again. So next time if you fly, so I'm pretty sure. What are glitter dots? Glitter dots is a sheet with stickers. And I don't have them here at hand. So do I know where I have them? I don't know. So polish this one. You see, and then you have a classic with red and green. I like that as well. So there are easy peasy to do, of course. And then if you have different patterns. And I'm dipping them all in the glitter. And I do that because if I stack them in my little pizza box, I don't want them to be sticky. I don't like them to be sticky. Because otherwise I damage something, so I don't want to do that. Here we go. Oh, and I got the pie yesterday. It was in a pizza box. Pizza box is perfect to make a glitter tray as well. I just made one, but a glitter tray with a pizza box is fantastic. Okay, like that. You see, so now two different ones, same design. So what came off here, I used as a stencil, and I can use that again and again and again and again. So next one. This one. I need to try this one. This one screams silver and white to me. That one is. That can be nice. That can be nice on this one. But I have some more space on this one. Or this one, let me try. I want to try them all. The big pizza box, the pie came in a large, like a regular pizza box, and that was great for the glitter, to put the glitter in. So a large pizza box, a regular one, to make a glitter tray from. Let me do this. Find what I want to use. I think I'm going to use this part. Ta-da. And of course, so this is the doily, so it has nothing to do with Christmas, but it will make a great pattern, I'm sure. So now with this one, I can cut a few and then make smaller stencils, but this one I want to keep in one piece because I will use that again, but I might cut another one that I make in smaller pieces. But, and I will do that so I don't get the glitter everywhere on that stencil. But I'll show you what I do to keep the glitter, because I don't want glitter all over that thing. That's a waste. And it's harder to clean off then. But this one, if I pour the glitter like this, it's not going to be on all over the place. So, but silver, do I have some silver? It would be nice if we have some silver foil, but I don't think I have that here. Let me see, what's this? Oh, that's a nice one. Kind of I have a piece of, I need to bring more glitter. This is a piece of it has silver and blue in it. So I'm just going to put a little bit at the top here. And then I'm going to do, so just a little bit of foil. I think that's nice. Then I'm going to do, I'm going to do the, what did I use? The soft teal, that will be nice. I use that on, hello Maureen from Hawaii. Never been to Hawaii, I need to go there, eh? You could use a release from the alphabet dies. Oh, that's also nice. That is also a good idea. Oh, and I have, you know, I should not forget. I didn't press it down well here. I did not press it down well here. Let's see if I can save that. I have a sneak peek. Another sneak peek. I know it drives you nuts, but I will do that at the end of this one. Because everything got kind of staggered a little bit. Oh, that's nice, Ruby. Now we try to make a reservation for tonight here, but things are changing again. We need to have vaccination proof for restaurants if they or the restaurants close, or if I don't know. It all changed the day before yesterday. Again, so new rules and regulations. Hospitals are too full here. Alberta is not doing well. Okay, so that is going to be, but I messed up on this side, but I think it will still be very pretty. So I see a little bit of foil, and when I lift it up, I will show you. I know, yeah, sneak peek, yeah. Okay, so I'm going to lift this up. Oh, it's actually, you don't see it, but I know I messed up on this side, but it's actually, you don't see it that much. But look how pretty that stencil is. You see, and because I poured it that way, from the stencil, there's a little bit of glitter here where my mess up was. But the rest is nice, so it's ready to go. Oh, Belinda, when do you need to go for work, Belinda? When do you need to go? So it will be a joint release, because we had to wait for the products a little bit again, but it will be a joint release from Esther and Josette. Esther has a few Halloween pages, and Josette has some fall, more fall stuff, and a little witch as well. But so that is, and I think it's coming on Monday, if I'm correct. I think it's coming on Monday. Yeah, Kathleen, I know I have a little oopsie there, but that's fine. It is in this pattern, because it's not, we are in Alberta. Yes, it's not, there are going to be rules if you can, well, I think if I'm correct, the restaurants, if they ask for vaccination, they can stay open or proof of test or whatever, but I don't know exactly. But so we were trying to get, because I think it's starting tomorrow or something started already, limited in stores again, like two-third of capacity, I think. So, changes. Yeah, Jennifer, the craft store will be the Into the Woods collection. And so Into the Woods and the full release from Ilse and Charlene and the Home Jungle sets. This is a pretty one. This is actually really pretty. And I know that would make a great stencil. Kind of look archy-fartsy, this one. Okay, so this one will have a... No, I think also. Why am I... I like the golds. No, let's do a silver one on this one. Let's do a silver one on this one. Hello, Marja. Hello. Okay. That is a pretty one, you see? You can see it well. I will take a picture afterwards. But I will take a picture of all the... Because I did not take a picture, I think, on the last one. From the ornaments. So I will make a picture, a nice display of all. Yeah, yeah, the collection from Ilse and Charlene, correct, yes. And Charlene, so I will do the first 2 hours on the 90th and the 20th, 8 a.m. UK time, so that will be 9, I think, in the Netherlands. Charlene will do the live, so she will do the show on the Ho Chanda channel or on the craft store. Did you say those funeral things? No, Belinda, that will be a stores only then. Yeah. You see, so I really like that one. This will be really nice if you make a few of this one. Here, on the card itself, on the background. That will be really pretty. Really pretty. Okay, next. And I like that with the foil as well. What else do I have on stencils? I do have... Oh, you know what I thought as well? That would be pretty. Because I want to... So I have my pizza box. I want to put an ornament on here. But I want to have more here. So I was thinking... If I put this on the side here. And then an ornament in the middle. So let me do that. So this is sticky. That's the sticky stuff. But then I need to trim it straight. Because I want to have my box ready. I don't know if this is going to work. I have to say... I don't know if this will work, but I thought this would be great if I can get some color here, some glitz, and then an ornament there. Let me see. Might be not a good idea, but I'm going to try anyway. And otherwise, embossing powder will save me. But I don't know if it's a good one to use. But I was looking at that because I need to finish I need to put an ornament on there. On my ornament pizza box. Let me see. Oh, I think I'm good. Tricky. Take a release sheet here. Oh, you know what? It's going to be messy because I have acetate there. So on the acetate, it will stick. I need to have that here. Oh, let's. I might get myself in trouble here, but you know, so this one doesn't make it, so I need to trim off this one. I cannot do embossing powder because then I melt my plastic, and if I do glitter, it's going to be over the acetate. So talk about messy, this might get a little bit messy, but I'm still going for it. There, I have a little piece left here as well. Maybe I do a little bit in the corner here. It's actually pretty nice. Oh, let me see. I need to round off these corners. Kitty cat isn't there. Belinda, go to Canada. Kitty cat is... Okay, I don't know. This one. I can do it like this because I already have it straight there. Okay, go try that. Try to put anti-static back on acetate parts. Oh, okay. I actually do, you know, I never use that, but I do have it. And I think I would know where it is here. So I will pick it up and see how that works. That's a powdery back, correct? You mean? And the powdery back. I will look it up. Oh, else stuck here. Stuck. I think I'm good. The anti-static powder. Give me 1 second. If I know where it is, I will. Because again, it's a small house, so I will be back in 5 seconds. Count me down. Am I in 5 seconds? This is. I got this for ages. I don't even know that company still exists. The little pouch. Printing, stamping, inkgrain, embossing. Scrap perfect. I don't even know if it's still... You see, never used it. Weird, eh? Weird, weird, weird. So let's try. Make sure this is pressed down well. I know, was it in time? Was it 5 seconds? Was it 5 seconds? Oh, now I need to do that first, of course. I know, Belinda, that's why I say it's small. It's a small apartment, but I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Okay, so this should be it. So you say this on the acetate. It'll be so interesting to see. Because again, never used it. Never used it. Is it too much or is that okay? So if it works, that I would have learned something today. I see all Honora. Honora's watching. Honora's. I see a lot of Honora. Here we go. So tap it off, probably. And now do the glitter. Okay, let's see. Going to be interesting. Oh, my script. Yeah, Belinda, that's too late. Your comment is too late. It's always a little bit behind. But there's going to, yeah, we'll see. And that's fine as well. That's fine as well. It doesn't need to be perfect. But I think this... So now you see again, by the way, you see how nice this will be. If you, for instance, have a, like that rectangle piece of tape on the cardstock, this will be a really, really nice stencil if you kind of put it on there like that. Pretty. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Okay, so on my box, I think I want the... No, I want a white. I'm going to do white. White, white, white. Hello, Diane. Technician is waiting for the glitter to come. Oh, yeah, there's... Yeah. It works. It does work. Fantastic. So now the question is, did it scratch? Let's see. So now we need to clean that again. Where do I clean that with? With a brush? Let me get this back first. Yeah, so for the the glitter and the tape, we have the, it's a Spotlight special. Use code SPOTLIGHT20 for 20% discount on glitter and tape. So whoever gave me the advice of the pouch, thank you. Was she? I don't know, you know, I don't know who that was anymore. I am a whooshy like that. Okay. So did it scratch? No, I think we're pretty good with the... I actually really like this look. It might have scratched a little bit, but not... No, I think I'm fine. It might have had some scratches already, by the way. Yeah, I think it scratched a tiny little bit. But not that it bothers me. At all. That is cool. That is cool. I know, never stop learning. So we need to... So what I always tell you about the tape, keep the tape at hand. I should have this at hand. Yeah. Oh, Maya, is the white glitter sold out? Maya, I will make... If that's true, I will make sure it gets there again. Okay. The white glitter. Okay, I will ask. I will ask the office because we might need to send it in from the Netherlands too. So now, because my idea was to put this one on there, you see, and that's why I thought about those circles, because then you have the circles kind of from this. And this, so this is from the Into the Woods collection. So you see, that can be used for winter, because I think this is a really nice wintry pattern as well. That is a nice pattern. So that one, and do I want to have another one? I have to kind of the same one. I think I'm going to just keep it simple with one ornament. Or do I want to have two on there? I was also thinking, like, that is nice. Kind of two the same. And then in the silver and the white. And this is both with that I die cut the part on there. And then I need twine. I know I have twine here, but I will do that later. But I think two or one. Just like in a circle. No, it's a storage box. So I'm going to do one. I also have a real white one. Oh, and those are the glitter dots, by the way, on here. So those are the glitter dots. No, the blue one. Stick with the plan, Al. Stick with the plan. So this one now, I need to put some two bulbs. Are we in for two bulbs? I think just one. Okay, I stick with one. One. Okay, Maya. And Maya, was it the white glitter that is sold out in the Netherlands? The white glitter. I'll make sure I get it back there. Thank you for the feedback, guys. Burnishing will help with burnishing. Oh, so honestly, just do it with your finger. That is honestly the best way. And then you keep a Swiffer. I have a Swiffer here at hand. And I can do... what is the proper name for the pizza box? It is the pizza box, Di. Anna, if you are still here... I know Anna is on location. If you still have Anna, can you put the link? I think the pizza box is sold out in the US, by the way. But it is coming very quickly. Okay, thank you, Maria. I will ask them to kind of take a look at the glitter and send a shipment of glitter to the Netherlands, because I think we might need to restock some. So this one is going here. I want to have it centered. It should be centered in the middle. Like there, and then straight. Kind of. Am I good? Sorry. You know, I don't do crooked very well, so I want to have it straight. There we go. Nice. So now my pizza box is ready for all my ornaments. But I'm going to do, but I know I have that, I have some twine, so like some gold thread. So I'm going to hang it, but that's pretty cool. So that is my storage box for all my ornaments that I made this week. I should have two, like one finished ornaments and one ornaments cut. Did anybody get a chance to get that wine box already? I like this as well. I was going to show you that one. Let me get this one out. And then in, yeah, love it. And that pattern, you see that's, and it's called something with water. I don't know the name, sorry. I don't know the names yet. But will you show me the glitter box from under the dryer? Yeah, Jessica, this is actually my, I have this one as a glitter tray in, is it the same box? I think, yeah, it's the same box. This is actually my embossing box. So I decorated this one. My glitter box is at home. So I decorated like a like another one of those boxes. And then, no, this one, oh, this is a different one. This was actually from chocolates. Where do I have the rest? So this I actually have for my embossing powders. But I made it into, you see, I decorated the, this was from a from chocolates. Yeah, so I painted the whole thing and I decorated the lid. But since I don't have my other one, I love, because I, you know, I did this. This is a, like a, how do you call that? Papieren zakdoekje. It's Kleenex with ink. And Annika made that one, did some washi tape, some wooden letters that I found. This is from the art journal collection. The stencil from the art journal collection. Just play, that's my saying. So I put that in the box. And then inside the box, I actually put, oh, you see, so I put the date there, so that was in February 21 at Josette's house. So Tom made this, the piece you see him gluing here, that's what he made in the back here. And this is Annika's Kleenex that she's making here. We actually showed a video at the time. So she did it with felt tips, just regular felt tips. Oh my God, Belinda, those chocolates that were in here were really, really, really nice. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Anna. So that's that one. That's probably the YouTube to the link to the box. So let's do the striped one. So I did it in this one. So I'm going to do it in another shape. So again, white cardstock with tape. Oh, I don't need this. I need a piece of release sheet. And what you do, you take this off. And of course, you can do this on, if you take a cardstock one, you can do just strips of tape. But if you do, if you want to have glitter everywhere, you need to kind of do it on a tape background. So you basically tape your tape go over a bit and tear it. And then make sure you press it down, but of course this will press down really well. Let's do another one. You can leave some more openings, and I have more glittered techniques with, Amaya, this is so much fun to do. Then I have the thin one here, so let's do the thin. So I have the 3 mil, purchase an ink pad or dye, doesn't make, I know Jennifer, that's true. And this one okay, I'm fine. I need to see that I go straight, need a little bit of larger opening. And then of course, if you want to line up perfectly, you can actually, I can go this way as well. You see, I can, oh, don't touch the tape else. Where's my release sheet one? Oh, this one. You see, so you can go diagonal as well. So I can line this up against there and I go that way. There's so many ways you can use that tape to make patterns. I know I make a plaid and on the card ones. Oh, no, I don't know if you can, that's an old one. Like I did a plaid on a background card with a poinsettia on it. I don't know if that's actually on YouTube. And I might go, I tell you what I'm doing right now. I might go a little bit crooked, but then I can actually fix that by just putting another line over it. But these are fun. I love doing these projects. So I'm going a little bit over again. You see, so now we have just a different pattern. And that's what we call playing. Just play. I just showed you my box. That's what we do. So you cut your tape. And these are really fun projects to do, I think. That is just, you know, you sit, relax, take a few colors of glitter. And you could take your wider tape as well. There we go. So now I have 3 and 3. I'm going to do one small one at the bottom here. And then I will start glittering that one. There we go. Oh, sorry, tape on my hands. There we go, one little piece for the bottom. I can pick it up here because I know I only need a small piece, but there we go. So do one at the bottom here. And then we will start decorating. And you see the different colors there, because you can do all your lines different colors if you want to. Okay, so that's that. Oh, Karen, the pizza boxes are great. Great, great, great. I know I'm playing tonight with florals, dyes, and glitter. Oh, Summer, that will be nice as well. Post that, please share your ideas. Yeah, because if you do the florals in glitter, then you can color on that with Copics and... So many fun things to do. Okay, so let's get the glitter out. Shall I try? I'm going to try. Oh, I was going to do that. I really like the colors from the other one. Let's do this. So again, a little bit of foil. And then I'm going to add some glitter. Oh, you don't see a lot of that. Let it tip maybe. Maybe I can do some foil on the tip, that will be fun. Oh, I'm putting a stick there, that's not. There we go. Maybe in between here a bit. So just play with, you know, with the things you have. There, a little bit here. And you will hardly see it, but it will still be a difference. So let's go, I'm going to do silver. I'm going to stick with some, like, light colors with this one, and you'll see that with one of the tapes I overlapped a little bit, but I can then add another strip of tape over it later to correct that. But it's almost time. Maybe I'll just do a diamond for the because I also need to do that little sneak peek. Laura, there is difference in foil, I have to say, but this one I don't know the brand anymore. I just have pieces. So if you have foil, try it on a little piece of, take some cardstock, put tape on there, and then try it on a little piece. It needs to come off easily. It needs to come off easily, but I have one or two at home that I know are not working that well. And I don't know if that's because of hot foil or not hot foil. I honestly do not know. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I cannot do one color. That will not be fun. I'm going to take this one off first because that's overlapping a bit, which is fine. Oh, let's do this in the same color then. And I probably take care of that problem right away. I see this one overlaps a little bit as well. So what I could do, I will tell you what I could do as well. This, and then I'll take this as well. So I will go do two different colors. So what I will do this one in gold, and then the other one, or in the blue streak. So that is kind of a blue, so it's darker as the silver, but because I have a little bit of blue in that foil, I know this will not, this will be fine. Even if there's a few specks in there. There we go. And then I'm going to polish this one. So what you could do if, so polish away from the edge. So if I would have, done two different colors and this overlaps a little bit, I could just take the 3mm tape and go over it again and then glitter it. So yesterday when I was at Carol's place, after that, oh Carol, I don't know if Carol's still here. I went to the sewing store. Like there's a quilt store, the sewing room it's called in Calgary. And the amount of, if you don't like quilting, you would like fall in love with it over there. So I found some fun stuff for my journals and for my fall. And I'll show you, it's super cool. I did you call it a splurge? Because I bought fabric and I might, you know, we talk about, if you talk about the paper from Ilse and Charlene, one to stroke and one to use, that is what that is. I'm going to take the cool diamond for those. And I was looking for cheesecloth because Ilse and Charlene use it a lot in there. And I did found that in another store. Oh, sorry. I should have done it over my trash can. I found it in another store, but then I already spent in the, yeah, Deco Art. Oh, Belinda, that might be the one that I have here, the Deco Art. The Deco Art, because that's the one that has this different colors. You are correct. Those are the rolls, correct? That's what I have at home. So I probably took pieces of those. Oh, Gina, I'm almost done. But you can watch back, eh? You can watch back. So polish this. And then this one will have a, well, let's do a silver. Keep it kind of in the cool colors. In the cool colors. You see how much fun this is to decorate, just play. Look at that. Look at that. Love that. So that is that one. And so let me put this aside. You see, so I will take a picture of all my ornaments because I did not do that. I think I forgot on Wednesday. So I will just take and put them outside or here on my sheet and take a picture of all those beautiful. You see, you take a Swiffer, and if there's any glitter, that will pick it up. That will pick it up. You see, so those are the ones. And where are the other ones? In my box. So you see how much fun you can have by just playing with all the different designs you have. And earlier this week, for the people that missed it, we did all the snowflake ones. And that was a 2-hour special. So we had 12 to 1 and then 1:30 till 2:30. So, and again, like this one, really, really nice stencils. This one on a, yeah, so many. Yeah, I always like, I also did with circles, I did that. But I really like that as well, the stripe ones. So that is that. And so, you know, to get in the mood for the sneak peek, let me show you because I bought felt. So sneak peek, drum roll. Okay, get my thing. So I'm only going to do a little sneak peek. Of course, the rest you will see on. So I'm going to change my table to a full table. Look at that. I bought that felt in gorgeous, gorgeous colors. Look at that. Pumpkin. Pumpkin. So that's wool felt. Love it, love it, love it. And I also bought like a waxed linen or something. And then this. Look at that. Oh. You see, that's to stroke. But the fabric, look at the colors. So I go to use it in my journal, in my planner, on cards. Fabulous. Fabulous. Okay, but that's the kind of the full. I'm going to show like one little thing, of course, because I, wait, let me get like cover my Christmas. So we go from Christmas to winter to fall. See, got it there. Got it covered. So this is going to be like, I think this is the color for the Halloween. Color for the Halloween, of course. Then this is a little sneak peek from Josette's collection. I made that one and oh, adorable. And I actually used fabric on this one. I will do that. I will do this one next week somewhere. Because I use jeans, I use linen for the hats, I use fabric. And that, so if you don't have the tape yet, make sure you get the tape. Because if you want to die cut fabric, you want to have, thank you for the hearts, thank you for the hearts. I know your set is out for dinner, but this was so much fun to do. So linen, jeans, other fabric, you need the tape for that. I know, Saskia, isn't that nice? You need the tape for that, because otherwise, you can, if you cut the fabric, you know, it's flimsy, it's, make sure you have the tape ready for next week. I even did a little birds with one side with tape, and then I glued them together. So you see, so they're on the back and the front, so they're more sturdy. Okay, so that will be your set. But look at the colors. Can you see that I was in love in that fabric store? That I thought, oh, so cool. But I'm going to another store in Calgary next week if it all works out, and then I will go to this fabric store again maybe, and then I'm going to show you one page in this one. One page in this one, estimate this one, but she used a picture from Tom. How cool is that? Do you see that overlay with the spider web? Do you see the pumpkin reinforcements? We get pumpkin reinforcements. Oh. And then the letters here and the little witch. And I'm pretty sure this is graphic 45 paper. It really looks like graphic 45. So Esther has three die sets for the planner, and Marjolein is our specialist in the, I have to say, any design team member that is here and that saw already what Marjolein did with the collection from Esther and from Josette. She is our specialist in Halloween. It's her season. And my goodies, if you're in for a treat next week, you're in for a treat next week. So I think it will be Monday. So if everything works out, then I will do my live on Monday. Although I'm out of bed like at 4, I think, to do the thing from Ilse and Charlene, the Into the Woods. And of course this on the with the Into the Woods paper. And I make pictures with the barn, if you have the barn. So cool. But then Into the Woods paper with the fall and the... Can't wait. So, that is it. I think I showed enough to get you ready for next week, to get you playing with the ornaments. Just push it through the metal die with... So this is a wool felt that I have here. So I'm pretty sure I can die cut this, but I always put adhesive on the back. So, with fabric, adhesive on the back. Then I put it on printed paper, so it's not sticky right away, and then just die cut it. So it works perfectly. But I will work with that next week for sure, and I'm going to implement that with the collection from Ilse and Charlene. Kind of mix and match everything. Can't wait. So thank you all. It's a little past after one, and I'm pretty sure Joep and Tom will just walk through the door in a second. So have a wonderful weekend. And I hope to see you at the craft store on the 19th and the 20th, being the ODS then. Bye-bye.